Hi, welcome back to my channel and happy Friday. Today I want to share with you the after the pin inside my A5 five-year diary, which I'm using as a sketchbook doodle book. In here I have the A5 HON as well as my traveler's notebook, like a standard size that I've been using to track my meals, exercise when I should be exercising and I'm not. And in here is my cousin A5 size, which I use as my daily dump. Over here, this is Bruce's journal. This is A6 that I've been using to track his health. I did a short on the weekly supplement. I will link that down below to give you an idea of how I've been using it to track the bathroom, his medication. I'm gonna try and film a video later today showing you the rest of it, because I also have a Hobonichi notebook back here that I've been keeping track of his health, because Bruce does have unfortunately, he has a lot of health issues that I need to keep track of for his vet. I will have chapters listed down below, so you can jump to whatever you want to see of these three planners. So let's start off first with my cousin. This is the monthly layout for last month. I'm not really shy about what I put down in here when it comes to decorating. And as you can see right now, thankfully, it is still thin. It's not chunky yet. So this is for December. This is for January, and I've kept it pretty simple. Thankfully, not much is happening right now other than Bruce's appointment. I had to cancel my appointment, and then we had an extra water delivery because on the 5th, we had an earthquake. We didn't have a lot of water bottles in the house, and so I went ahead and placed an extra order for delivery. Now let's go to the week. So this is for this week. Washi tapes from Daiso, and I generally don't pre-plan other than putting down the washi and any packages that I might expect for the week. I generally plan the night of or the morning, so today's Friday morning, so I will list down the task that I need to get done for the day. This is for last week. Okay, well, I still haven't done anything for January. I will probably use this as my currently page. And then I haven't done anything. So this is the 1st, 2nd, the 3rd. On Friday, on the 5th, we had an earthquake in Lytle Creek. It was 4.2. And it's funny, a lot of people felt it. I didn't. It was rumored that it might be a precursor to the big earthquake that I don't want to say we're expecting, but it's been, I think, more than 20 plus years since we've had a really big earthquake. So I decided to write it down. So on Monday, I was trying to catch up. I found this picture of this. It's an Arctic scale worm, and it looks like an alien. Look it up. It is just a fascinating creature. So that's the name of it right there. And so I sketched it in pen. And then I watercolored. I generally put the pencil board underneath the page before I watercolor, but I forgot to do it. And so do you see the crinkliness? So the water, because I was watercoloring like this without the pencil board, it sort of soaked through. So if you look at this page, I didn't watercolor this one, but I don't know if you can tell, but it's crinkly also. That also tells you how much water I used to put on this page. So I found that interesting. I can't remember if when I watercolored in last year's cousin, if it did the same thing. I want to say no, but again, I generally use the pencil board underneath and then I watercolor, and then that way the pencil board stops the water from, you know, dampening the pages behind it. This is for Monday. This is Kit Kat. This is our neighborhood cat, and he likes to come and visit Bruce. So this is Bruce, and he's the one that I keep his health planner. Bruce is a dog that we adopted in 2018 from a rescue. Unfortunately, he has a lot of health issues, which is why I think they found him on the streets in really bad condition. And then that's Kit Kat's
paws. He was trying to get into the bedroom.
That's him sticking his paws, trying to open the door. So we eventually let him in, which is his happy face right there.
Again, so here's the creature that I drew.
I like this image, so I went ahead and taped him down. I used double-sided tape, and I cut little pieces on different parts of the drawing and then tape it down. I don't use the double-sided tape over the entire image on the back. That way I can stretch the double-sided tape. On Wednesday, I found some buds, some flower buds on my mom's cymbidium. Finally blooms, I can share the flowers with her. Here's Bruce, he's starting to feel better. He's been under the weather lately with his ears and his eyes. But on this day, on Wednesday, he was feeling pretty good. This was something that I drew yesterday. So this will date me, but I discovered yesterday that gum called fruit stripe. So this was something that I ate when I was a kid. I chewed on it as a kid. They're discontinuing it. So I decided to draw it. I don't know if I'm gonna color this. If you look at the packaging, it has crazy stripes, which represents the gum. That's Bruce. He's getting up from the couch. But I kind of like the pencil sketch. This came in 5 flavors, and it's wet and wild melon, cherry, lemon, orange, and peach smash. I did draw the gum in here, which I will show you here in a second. So that is a flip of my cousin. In here is my A5 HON that I've been using as my writer's notebook. This is the book that I have beside me all the time. And this is where it's functional. So this is the traveler's notebook standard size. I've been using this to keep track of my weight and steps on this layout. So here is my weight. Here is my steps. So far, so good. And because this is with me in here every single day, I'm able to fill this out. I initially had this in my standard traveler's notebook, and it just wasn't working to have so many planners stacked beside me. So having it slipped in here has been fantastic because I've been able to keep up with this. So this is for this week. Again, unfortunately, good intentions, wanted to do my arm weights and my exercise, haven't done both. Down here, I started keeping track again of my liquid intake. And then over here are my vitamins. Let me pull on that. Over here, I keep track of my meals. So I have breakfast, lunch, dinner, and snacks. That's Bruce with his toy. Bruce, Bruce. My sleep is over here. My writer's notebook, A5 HON hardcover. This is the Tiny Dragons. And let me show you. The only thing I can really show you is the weekly layout. So this is what this looks like. And can I show you the, yeah, I can show you this. So this is the monthly layout. The only thing I'm keeping on here are the important appointments. Words are hard today. Over here is an appointment that I need to, I did cancel it because of the earthquake. I stayed home for the water delivery. Sorry about that. Bruce is jumping around, which is making my camera shake. Really simple. Initially, I had put washi down on the bottom, didn't like it, took it out, put it into my cousin. I've been doing the highlighter for my to-dos, outlining it in black pen. This one is functional. This is where I make it pretty, and with all the stickers that you saw earlier. The mail I would put on this side. So this is for the first week of January. Now for this week, same thing with the to-dos. I really like this. I'm not putting down that much washi on this thing. I have the heater on. It is really cold. And I had this washi tape from Cookie Monster Co. I was lucky enough to get some from her. I went ahead and put it down. So I did the strip first because it's been cold all week. And then I decided to try just a washi strip just for the column itself. Today it's also cold. I think when we woke up this morning, it was about 40. Today I will list down what I need to do here. And then this is a washi tape that my nephew brought home for me from Japan. So this was my souvenir washi tape when he took his trip with my niece in November. I had to think about this one is to not chunk it up at all. And then in here are just stickers that I use for this. And finally, let's talk about the A5 5-year that I'm keeping in my vacancies cover. And let me show you what I've done.
Now I've been having fun in here. So I've been trying, this is a pencil board that I created myself using cardboard. You know what? Let's just go back to the near the beginning. So this is what I've been doing. Over here, I've been keeping track of the weather. Am I still in frame? It's harder when I'm not on the floor because of this table. Yeah, I think I showed you this last week. So that's a flying fish. This is a Peruvian Inca tern. Looks like it has a mustache. I also keep track of the humidity. Over here are two sea otters. When they sleep, they hold paws so that they don't drift apart from each other. And I just thought it was really sweet. And so that's what I was trying to draw there. So this is from 2023-24. And as I flip through the pages, that's what you'll see, is that 2023 I've kept in this corner. 2024 I will try to keep on this corner. And then I'm guessing 25, 26, maybe 27. This one says that squirrels plant thousands of new trees each year by forgetting where they put their acorns. Here is a big tortoise, and it says that tortoise and or turtles can breathe through their butts. Now, how they know this, I don't know. That was from boardpanda.com. Seahorses are the same thing for life, and then when they travel, they also hold each other's tail. So that's what that looks like. Now with this one, remember in my cousin, I was talking about the gum. There it is. The Fruit Stripes gum by Ferrera Candy has been discontinued. So I drew the packaging in here. I thought it would be fun to draw what the gum strips look like. Let's go backwards. So drawing this yesterday made me think about candies that I used to eat when I was a kid a long time ago. I think this still exists. It's called Nerds. So instead of coloring it in, I wanted to show you how I generally, I guess, sketch, doodle in here. Spruce, spruce. So I would do it in pencil, then I outline it with a black pen, and then I color it in. So this is what my doodle looks like for Nerds. So I'm gonna color it in later. And this was the last one that I did last night. This is, I don't know if anybody, I think this still exists too, but we used to get this at the liquor store for 10 cents. So that makes me sound so old. But it was, candy was cheap back then. I'm pretty sure I got this for 10 cents or a quarter after school. And this was, okay, I'm gonna stop there. But this is hot cinnamon toothpicks. And these were just so much fun to chew on because they would burn your mouth on it like a rabbit. I thought I would draw this in because this was the packaging when you bought it. This is what it looked like. And I just thought it was funny. So I went ahead and sketched them in. That is it for now. I hope this was an interesting video for you to watch. If you like my video, give it a thumbs up. And if you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe if you'd like to see after the pin video. Have a good weekend, and I'll see you guys next week. Bye.